Hello?
I'm back.
Oh, okay. Let me just add Michael back in.
You guys, you want to talk to a producer? Was it me?
It was just you. Yeah, one sec. I'll just get Michael online. Okay.
Hi there.
Yeah, so what I was asking there was, are you saying that it is possible for a person to, who does not to have to have money to get the goods and services that they want, that you know, that you, without entering commerce, is that?
How can you not enter commerce, for one? But mainly, what do you mean by person?
A human being.
What do you mean by human being?
Man or woman, stick to that one.
Man or woman.
that I understand. Okay. Man or a woman. A human being, is that a color of man?
No, it's
could
a
that, could that be a person?
It's a live person, yeah.
Well, is there such a thing? Or is it just a persona? I give up.
I don't know. But I know that I am a man, and I have a need for shelter and...
Wait a minute. You know you are a man. Or could you be a spirit using what looks like to be a man's body?
Well, both.
Holy cows. Well, then maybe that's why you use a driver's license for identification, huh?
Well, I prefer not to. I haven't put it to the test yet.
Think about
sometimes,
it.
Sometimes, you know, if sometimes it's more convenient to use the artificial entity, you know, to get what you want.
Get what you need. When you get what you want, that usually gets me in trouble. Anyway.
So, without too much accent on definitions, I don't know, you know, this whole system is being created. Let's say it's been created for our benefit. And the government does want to, the government wants things to go the way that they want them to go, let's just say. They have their definition. My understanding is that the government wants to control the population.
What evidence do you have of that?
I've got it by way of documents that refer to the process, like the Creature from Jekyll Island book by Griffin and the Iron Mountain group.
Yeah. You believe everything people tell you?
No, that's why I'm talking to you. But the fact there are people in government quite clearly who have an agenda, and they have to be contended with, but I don't want to get into that. I'm just asking about, you know, how can a person exist? How can a man or woman exist on this planet using this body? Or is it possible for them to exist on this planet using this body without having to use money to get what they want?
I don't know. Get what they want could get you in trouble. But get what they need? Heck, if I saw push come to shove, I'd go right down to that grocery store and I'd help myself to the counter. And I'd ask the clerk, anybody got a claim on this stuff? And he'd probably look at me like, duh. And I'd say, well, fine, thanks. You see, as nobody's using it, I'm using it. And I'd walk out the door with it and take it from there. If all comes worse to worse, at least I'll have a place to stay for the night, you know?
Okay.
Well, I got a question about that process. Is there a requirement for, you know, contract and proper notice with that, and is that sufficient notice?
Well, what else is it? You asked it if anybody had a claim on that stuff. Nobody spoke up, so you took it. What's the problem? What's the difference between that and a squirrel walking under an oak tree picking up an acorn and walking off with it? You're going to arrest the squirrel for helping himself for what's there? Nobody was using it?
Well, there's a difference in that, you know, you've got the product of nature that's not been touched or improved on or anything by man or any processes.
So?
And then, you've got all the other people in that creation and delivery chain, and the guy at the counter isn't necessarily the one with the authority with regards to anything about the products.
Well, the point of the matter is, who was using it when you picked it up? Nobody. You picked it up. It's there. It's used. Unless somebody's using it, how's anybody have a claim to it?
Well, let's change the metaphor. What if there's a coat in the store and you're cold, so you pick the coat off the rack and you start to walk out with it? Then we know what's going to happen. The store is going to send someone after you.
Hey, do you? Maybe, maybe not. I had a friend of mine I used to hang around with. He'd walk out of the store with a TV. He'd go pick it right up off the shelf and walk right out the store with it, put it in the car and drive. He did it a number of times. You don't know what they're going to do till you do it. If they stop you, say, what's the problem? What are you going with that? What business is it of yours? You know? Did I take this from you? No. But what's the deal here? That's not stealing. That's just taking what's there. The only time you get in trouble for stealing is if you admit you think you're stealing. The time, you know, I don't know how it is now, but it used to be, if you walk out of the store with it in your hands in plain sight, it's no problem. But if you hide it, they'd arrest you. They call it shoplifting.
Oh.
And then you admit to it, stealing, so you get it. But the point of it is, hey, nobody was using it, so I picked it up, and I'm using it. What's the problem?
Wow.
Does that make any sense? I don't know how other to explain it. But.
Yeah, no, that does make sense. But, you know, it's one of those things that I've never seen put to the test, so I don't know how it would go.
Well, like I say, I had a friend that used to do it. That was many years ago.
Interesting.
Now, I've heard you comment that everything is paid for numerous times, you and Boris. And I'm curious with regards to what the explanation for that is.
Other than
just saying it.
Everything's here. Somebody made something out of something. So what? It's still, could they have made it if it wasn't already here? Could they have made it if the body they were given to use was making it? No. It's all here for us to use. Do what you love to do. Take what you need, and everybody be happy. Problem is, we got a bunch of greedy bastards running around. That's why they think they need money. That's why they think they need ownership. They think they know better than God. They think they have an inheritance. As far as I know, God's still alive. But they want to claim their inheritance. They want to kill off the old man. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Yeah, I see where you're going. So if the product is there, it's like you said, someone's paid for it, someone's produced it, it's there.
Well, someone, did they really produce it, or did they just manipulate it to appear to be something they thought was worthwhile to make, you know?
Well, let's say you think that you need a car, so you go to the car dealership and they hand you the keys and the salesman gets in and wants you want to go for a test drive. You just tell him to get out, I'm taking his car. they wouldn't send the cops after you for that.
Well, good. Then you explain to him. Heck, he gave me the keys. I said, I'd take it. He says, I asked him if it was his car. He says, no, it was Mr. So-and-so's. Or I says, well, where is he? I'd like to talk to him. Well, he never showed up. So, seeing I tested response, what, objection. He gave me the keys to the car, so I'm using it. What's the crime?
Well, if you take the car without paying, I guess they would.
What do you mean without paying?
That's what they would say.
I'm using. What do you mean I took it without paying? He said it wasn't his anyway. Nobody was there that says it was his. I had the keys. I'm using it. What's the problem?
Wow.
They won't arrest you for using it if you stay on point, I'd say. They might ask you, could you be so kind to give the car back? There's a problem here. Well, you believe they need it more than I do? I thought they had a whole lot of them there, but if you believe so, well, what's the problem? We can get, you know, let's bring it back to them.
So do you travel in a vehicle without license or registration?
the wife thinks she owns it, and she lets me use what she thinks she owns. I'm happy doing that. I don't care. I get what I need when I need it.
Okay. I just wondered how you put this philosophy, you know, in action.
I say, why make waves, man? If the wife's happy, yeah, that's a lot, you know.
That's the hardest thing to achieve. And the most essential.
Thing of it is, you know, I believe what I've learned, you know. I sleep fine at night now. I don't worry about whether the mortgage is paid or anything. I told her, any day you're ready, man, stop paying the mortgage. Let's see where it goes.
Okay. That's very interesting, because what was that, Michael, the theory of some people think that they can go and buy a house with a mortgage and then get the bank to cancel it? How do they do that?
I give up. If they can, good. God bless them. It works for them.
Yeah, well, maybe you lost Michael. Are you still there, Michael?
No, I'm still here. It was based on the fact that your signature creates the money in the system, and then somehow cancel the document because it's already been paid for by the creation of it. Something like that.
That's fucking dream world, like your signature. First of all, is it your signature or is it just ink on a piece of paper? And once you pass that paper to somebody else, how's it your signature any longer? And you're creating money with a signature? Only if the other asshole believes you.
Well, in the banking system, it works that way, that the money is created when you agree to the liability of the loan.
Maybe, maybe not, but how is it created, man? That's delusional, if you ask me.
Well, it is delusional, but, you know, I'm just asking how we can use the system to our advantage in that kind of a situation.
Well, there's a problem. Why use it to your advantage? Why not use it to the advantage of everyone?
Well, getting back to the point of shelter, if you need a place to have shelter, and how do you get it? There's no places being foreclosed on where we live here. This is Vancouver, and it's the hottest real estate market on the planet.
Yeah.
There's no foreclosed properties here. Garages are going.
Well, the way I look at it is, salespeople. Hold on. Hello. Hello. I hung up. Anyway, good. You missed out, man. If they answer, I usually have fun with salespeople. You guys still there? Ah, dropped again. Son of a bitch.
Batman.
I've been known to answer to that.
Thanks for taking the call. I really appreciate it. I'm thinking about maybe I can add in a friend of mine who's the one that gave me your. He's the one that forwarded me your files on these.
My files?
Well, the files the of these conversations.
Oh, the bat calls, you mean?
Yeah. Let me try to get Michael on the line.
Hello.
Michael, I've got Batman on the line.
Holy cow. Wham, bam.
He's been kind enough to take the call. So, Batman, this friend of mine, Michael, he's much more knowledgeable on this subject than I am. My name's Tom.
What evidence do you have that anybody's more knowledgeable on anything than anybody else? No, tell me.
There's the Batman I've come to love.
Yeah, he's listened to a lot more of your files than I have. So,
my files? Who's my? I thought they were the bat calls.
Okay, the bat calls. Okay. Well, they are partly your property, anyways. But you've been kind enough to share them.
What are they?
Partly your property.
What evidence do you have I own anything?
I don't have any.
Why would you say such a thing, then? You accusing your brother?
Of sharing, that's all.
Thoughts occur, man. I'm just passing it, you know, like, what's it? Shit through a goose or something like that?
So Tom has not listened to all the stuff with regards to the whole concept of not owning any property. So what's really cool about hearing you speak is when you challenge people on all of the assumptions and presumptions that we make that we don't realize that we're doing. So great reminders.
Well, am I challenging or am I just asking? Maybe you guys know something more than I do. Is that a challenge?
Well, for many people, being asked is challenging, so just a different word, meaning the same thing for many people.
I know what is asking offends people time to time. I think I ran into an undercover cop the other night I didn't run into him, but met up with one. Because the only one I see get that offended that quick when you're asking questions are police.
Yeah.
And this guy, he started, what's your name? And I says, your name? What makes you think I own a name? Everybody owns a name, he started right off the bat. Next thing you know, it went from good to bad. He was, he got pissy and he left.
Little bit of ego in there, eh?
Well, I think he was an undercover cop. That's what I think. He was a new face in the bar. I was just trying to make new friends, as usual, you know?
Yeah. Right. You must have heard of Charlie Sprinkle then.
Sounds familiar.
Charlie Sprinkle is if you Google on YouTube, if you look up Charlie Sprinkle, there's about a 7-minute interview with him. He's the one that was driving or operating a vehicle in the state of California without a driver's license for 30 some odd years. And very, very interesting story and kind of a quick one there.
I'm going on being without a driver's license for about 20 years now or something.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Yeah, it's getting around 20.
Now, one of your fairly recent conversations that was that's online, you mentioned that if things go the way that you think they're going to go, you may end up getting a driver's license. What did you mean by that?
Yeah, well, it'd be a lot easier than have to screw with the cop if he runs the plate and says it's somebody you best not mess with. I mean, would that be better?
Well, if you should watch that Charlie Sprinkle video. You know, I'll find it and Skype it to you.
I might have seen it already. So
he's got a different approach on it, and he explains himself very well. But you know, the Motor Vehicle Act where we are living here, and I think the Motor Vehicle Acts in a lot of jurisdictions, they talk about there being an owner of a vehicle, driver, and operator, and Charlie doesn't drive a car. He travels.
Oh, yeah, that's just semantics. I know what you're saying. The point of the matter is, if they're going to give me a driver's license and a plate to put on a vehicle that I'm using, who cares?
Yeah.
Why go through the bullshit? You know when they run the number, you know they're going to go the other way. They ain't even going to pull you over. Might not even get out of the car. They might turn the lights on, or they'll call the plate, and then the next thing you know, they'll wave at you and go away. Isn't that simple? I mean, to me, now, that's the way to do it.
Now, doesn't that kind of contradict the traditional position of people with regards to the fact that you've accepted the rules by applying for the license and therefore you're now within their jurisdiction?
Oh, you're in their jurisdiction if you're just using something. You know why people get in their jurisdiction? Have you been listening to the bat calls?
Yeah. Well, it's through voluntary consent and accepting.
They go in there claiming the name. They claim ownership right there to give the court jurisdiction. There's a controversy concerning the name. And what if you're just using it? Where's the controversy? The one who laid the claim now gets the liability. It's all fine. You want it? Have it.
Okay, so you're presenting the driver's license and the registration, and at the same time you're saying, I don't claim those names, I'm just using them?
I never say I'm not. I say, hey, is this what you're looking for? Well, the state... It says I could use this. Are you sure you want to take liability for it?
And how would they be taking liability for it?
Once they put it in their hands.
Okay.
Who owns it then? Who's got possession of it?
All right, so the possession is 9/10 of the law ownership issue.
So they tell me.
Yeah. Okay.
What's the problem if I'm using it? Is it a crime if I use it, Your Honor? Did I damage anybody by using this?
Right.
But besides, I think most of the licenses, I don't know, they used to say that are more or less property of the state, which is a fiction. I mean, so fine. It's the state's, man. You want it here. Talk to the state about it.
Yeah. I remember a few years ago hearing somebody say, "Is this, to the cop saying, is this you? As he points to the license, and he goes, "No, this is me. That's just an image."
Well, I'd ask him, "What do you mean by you? Is this you? Yeah. What's your definition of you? It looks like a piece of paper to me, but you call it whatever you want, I guess. You know, how are we going to have a meeting of the minds till I know what he talks about? Is this you? What's that? Is this you? What kind of question is that?
Interesting.
Is this you? Does that look like a you? Looks like a piece of paper. A you's got horns, man.
Now, they don't like that kind of stuff, obviously, because it's playing with the words, but...
Is it?
As far as they're concerned.
What do you think they're doing?
What do you think? Yeah, what do you think they're doing? Absolutely, yeah.
Hey, you want to play? I'll play.
It's all assumptions.
Took me years to get this attitude. It's fun now.
Can I have?
Yeah, go ahead.
I was just going to ask about this theory about that everything is already paid for. Is it your do you think that when the government creates the name, they create a trust kind of account? And does that trust account have assets in it, or just liabilities?
Who knows? What's assets? What one believes they need at the moment. Other than that, what good is it? And besides, is everything here? It's already here. Money's just an illusion, if you ask me, for people who think they got one step above their brother. I mean, other than that, what is it?
Yeah, it's for commerce.
Hey, I trust you'll do the honorable thing. I'm here to trust. They say money's the good faith and credit of the people, or the trust of the people. Other than that, what good is it? If you go to one so-called country and they don't want to take the American dollars anymore, what good is it going down there with them, you know?
Right.
I mean, it's all one's perception of what it is at the moment. People think that piece of paper is worth more than a loaf of bread. Fine, here, have it. I'm hungry. I want the loaf of bread. See?
Well, has anybody tried to gain assets or gain their share of the country?
What do you mean gain their share of the country? What do you want? You got what you need at the moment?
No, like let's say you don't have a house. And so how do you pay for it if you don't have their money?
What do you mean pay for it? Find one nobody's using, move in it, and see what happens.
Oh, well, they'd send the sheriff to get you evicted.
How do you know that? Have you done it yet? And why are they going to evict you? The only thing they have jurisdiction over is tenants, homeowners, and occupants. What evidence do you have that I'm any one of those? Where was you when I moved on this place? I mean, you know? Well, Bank of America, you know, they repossessed the house. Or not repossessed, they closed on this house. Oh, they closed on this house.
Foreclosed.
Foreclosed. You mean to tell me the account's settled then? Well, what's the problem if I use it?
Yeah, we don't have that problem here. The problem here is the prices of houses are ridiculously high.
Well, that's because you believe there's such a thing as money.
Well, how do you gain access to a property if you don't transact with the person who's the owner?
What I would do if I felt I had a need for a house, I'd probably look for one that was foreclosed, the bank foreclosed on, which is now it's an abandoned property, and I might give them notice, and I want to ask if there's anybody here who's laying claim to this property, and I'd like to talk to them face to face.
Oh, okay.
Because they're going to say, well, Bank of America owns it. Oh, well, can I meet Mr. Bank of America? Because I want to give notice, since there's nobody there, I'm using it. Any objections? And if anybody objects, on what grounds you objection? Well, I represent Bank of America, and he says you can't do that. Oh yeah? Well, I want to talk to Bank of America. Never mind you. You're just giving hearsay information here. Is that admissible in court now? See?
Ah, interesting.
Think about it. It's all in our faces. The problem is you're either claiming ownership or you're using it. You know? If you claim ownership, you're going to get taxed. How can you pay tax if you own nothing? You're just using Federal Reserve notes or whatever, Canadian dollars or whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're using them. Are they yours? No. You're just using them. So what's the problem? You get what you need? What's the problem? The world's here. Take what you need if nobody else is using it. Everybody, you know, thinks these corporations exist and they get all scared. Credit companies and all that. I want to meet them.
Yeah, they're legal fictions.
Whatever.
I have a question with regards to your bat calls and training process. Well, the bat calls, excuse me.
Excuse me of charging my brothers.
You apparently do some form of teaching by providing the information and your experiences on the calls. And I was wondering that what's your level of interest in helping to bring people's awareness to this information? Like you want to learn more in a slightly more structured manner so people can, you know, follow it in a little bit more,
detailed fashion.
Educational, detailed fashion that would probably help people get started in understanding it, because a lot of it is spoken at a fairly high level of understanding.
Is it?
Like, for many people, yeah. And if you were to start somebody from scratch who wanted to learn this stuff, like, what were the first things that you would want them to understand or think differently about?
First thing I want to ask them, do they know who the problem is?
Yeah. Yeah, they're the problem.
Well, that depends on the individual. I've talked to many people, and I haven't talked to much after I've talked to them, because they still believe everybody else is the problem. So, you know, it's each his own opinion. But far as what level, what do you think I'm doing now?
Well, that's what I say. You are doing it now, and I was, because a lot of the questions that are asked and a lot of the answers that are given are asked and answered from a certain level of education and understanding that new people wouldn't necessarily have.
Well, I'd say everybody has it, because you know what I've been telling people, the way I see it anyway, is forget all this bullshit you learned and go back to being a little child. You already know how to do that. I'm in kindergarten when I get in that courtroom or before a police officer. How can I help you? Oh, what do you mean by this? Oh, gee, exactly what is this? Or how can I help you, you see?
Yeah, so you don't assume anything, you ask the questions.
Well, until you understand pretty much, you know, a meeting of the minds with the individual, where are you going to go with it? Come as a little child, see? What's there to learn about that? We're all born with it.
It's to a large degree unlearning bad habits, right?
Yeah, in a sense, you know, we've come to the belief that we own something and we're in charge of what's going on. I'd say good luck. Like people says, oh, I want freedom. Yeah. Well, even if you had freedom, when's the last time you visited the moon? What if you wanted to go to the moon? You think you're free to go there? Is there such a thing as freedom?
Huh? Right. Well, it isn't in this society where the government has the need to control everything.
Oh, well, there you go now, blaming the government. You're talking, you're blaming. It's just like blaming Tinkerbell for your problems. Tinkerbell wants to control everything. Think about it.
Well, the government has given itself the authority to use police to enforce their will. So,
the government, what's the government made of, allegedly?
The people.
Yeah. You never think of them cops or the police or the councilman or whatever, or the judge as your brother or sister? And could it be the way you treat them is the way they treat you?
Well, no, that all makes sense to me. It's just that, like you alleged to earlier, when you try to have a conversation with a policeman, oftentimes they see it as a challenge to their authority, and they're the guys with the guns and the sticks, and they don't want to listen to your point of view. They're trained to solve problems by, you know, hauling people to jail or whacking them or something.
Yeah, that may appear so, but I've found. And many times I thought I was going to, well, not many, but a few times I thought I was going to get whacked by them the way I did it. But they freaking stayed in honor.
Okay.
Not with me, and I'll tell you, I told a cop one night I was going to kill him. They took me around back of building, not the cop I told, but a couple other cops who was going to teach me a lesson. And when they got me there, I knew I figured it was coming, And now they said to me, what do you got to say now, tough guy? And I, more or less, and I says, would you believe me if I told you I was sorry? And I laughed. And, you know, they didn't beat me up. It was...
Interesting.
All right. This is in the younger days.
So, are you saying that a person can exist in this, you know.
Illusion? Hello? Ah.
The only ones allowed to come are those who feel they can go right along with the master plan. And the only thing you got to bring is sitting there in your head.
Is that all? Well, that's all.
Well, that's all. Well, that's all.
So raise the sails and trim all the sheets. Set your course and jam.
Let your fortunes be cast to the the only kind we're out to find of those worth looking for. You can tag along should you feel the urge to merge, 'cause we're all agreed that all we need is hope and a little courage.
Is that all? That's all.
Ooh.
So raise the sail.
You're back?
Yeah, I don't know. It dropped again on me. I usually don't do it this bad.
Oh, no problem.
Hello, hello.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry about it. I had something's with this computer. It does this to me every now and then.
But, yeah, well,
you missed out. Sometimes that salesperson hung up on me, or whatever they want to be called. Sometimes I have a pretty good call. Have fun with them.
That's good.
Yeah, one gets scared and hang up on me the other day. They called the household looking for people with diabetes. And how do you find this stuff out? How do you know this? Well, maybe a friend or something. Well, who told you this? I want to know. I might have to turn them in for violating the Privacy Act. How do you guys find this stuff out? And then all hangs up on me. I wonder, probably won't call me back again, at least for a while.
So, just so I understand, is it correct then that the name is granted when there's a recognition of the event of a live birth, and the government owns that name?
Well, how's a fiction create anything, to be honest with you? It's people doing this.
Okay.
Now, the reason why I could see they're doing it is because maybe it's the Illuminati. Who knows?
Yeah.
The point of the matter is, I look at it as a gift certificate. And if you use it properly, everything's here for you to use. Well, if you claim it as yours, then it becomes identification instead of indemnification. And now you want the liability. What the creation has given you isn't good enough. So you've got to own it. Now, there's where the taxes come in, the fines come in, all the laws, regulation, and statutes come in. And I say, if you believe you own something, you ought to know all that stuff. It could come in handy.
Right.
I look at it, I just use it. And I accept the offer, and I say, how can I help? See? I appreciate it all being paid for, and by helping, it's how you treat your brothers and sisters. If you treat them with love and honor and respect, then there is no man's laws and statutes, if you ask me. Could it be that simple?
Yeah, as people try to make everything more complicated, of course, especially the people that want to control others.
Well, see how you are. Blaming your brother again. Some people.
Well, I know it isn't me.
So. Well, it isn't. See, how can I prove a negative? And besides that, could it be you get what you put out? Could it be you're the one trying to control, and they're just giving you back? Government allegedly is just a reflection of the people.
Well, you know, I understand why you're asking those questions, and those are good questions. In my personal situation, I just want to be left alone to do what I want to do and to help my friends and to help my fellow man. But I am getting interfered with.
Are you?
Yeah.
Or could you be interfering with yourself?
How so?
I don't know the whole story. How so? You tell me. You ought to know better than I do. Think about it.
Well, in my case, out of ignorance, I could say, yeah, probably.
Out of ignorance or out of thinking you know better than what you was born with?
That has gotten me into trouble a few times, sure. You know, one thing life teaches you to be is more humble.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, humility is a very good thing to have.
Yeah, remember, if you're the low man on the totem pole, you got only one place to go. And usually if you are and you're doing it honorably and humbly, those around you will lift you up. That way you won't have to worry about falling. But if you put yourself up there and nobody's there to catch you, then what happens, huh?
Yeah, no, that's a good point.
Just, you know, thoughts occur. It's a question that comes to mind at the moment, so I figured I'd share it with you. How's that?
That's good. No, there's wisdom in that for sure. There's a lot about life that people they assume and presume a lot of things that are not true, and then their mistakes flow from that.
Yeah. Well, it's a learning process. It's all good.
Yeah.
Go
ahead.
Sorry, you have addressed the process of staying in honor in court and questioning the presumptions that they're making with regards to how am I liable for the name and so on. And I was wondering with regards to processes before court in order to do that, some type of administrative process, or is there dealing directly with the prosecution before you get to court? Doing it honorably and administratively. Can you talk about that?
I guess. All I'd say is I'd try to talk to whoever believes they put a charge on the name. Because all you do, see what happens is they put a charge on the name and then they wait for you to argue about it. If you could, probably best bet is to go in there and talk to whoever's going to prosecute the case. And hey, how can I help you in this matter? Is that your name? Well, allegedly, I've been known to use it. Is that a crime? You know, talk with them. Go take them out to dinner. Go buddy-buddy, you know. Make them a cup of tea. How can I help you? How can we settle this matter honorably? Settle it before it goes to court. You might find it goes away.
Huh.
And then all else comes, and heck with the paper. You know, if I do anything for paperwork, that's what you're getting at. I might leave a handwritten notice or a memorandum for the clerk, if the attorney's not around, or whoever's got charged to the name. Say, hey, I believe there's a mistake in this matter. Let me know if I can help in any manner, and I can be reached at blah, blah number. Please call me friend, or whatever you like to be called. Or I've been known to answer to Batman, you know, whatever. And have a little one-on-one with him. That way, if he still push comes to shove, he goes before the court. Then you say, hey, judge, you know, we discussed this matter. This guy still believes there's a controversy concerning me. I'm just all ears. I want to hear him prove it.
Right.
Well, part of your discussions with him would be to question the presumptions, I am assuming.
Well, yeah, in general, it doesn't matter the name. Is it a crime for me to be using that name? I mean, who bought the charge on it? Well, the officer did. Well, would that make him liable? You know, you run a few questions like that before the prosecuting attorney and see if he still wants to go to court with it. If he does, fine.
Okay, and this basically same procedure for tax authorities?
Why not? Yeah, how can I help you? I'd love to pay you. What evidence do you have I own anything?
Well, let's say their evidence is a bank account.
You own a bank account?
Well, no. The trouble is not my understanding of who I am. The trouble is, or maybe that's part of it, but there certainly is a problem with the authorities. Let's talk about the tax authorities, who assume that the money in your account is the property of the taxpayer.
Well, see, now are they assuming? Or you just told me, you just said you're guilty. You just claimed ownership. Who's assuming here?
Well, if they send you a bill saying, we think you made this amount of money and we're going to just take it out of your bank account unless you object.
What's your object? What evidence do you have that I own it? I'm just using it. Is that a crime? What do you need? People just don't get how simple it is, if you ask me.
Yeah.
You claim ownership, man. Hey, you need it? Take it. They won't take it. Trust them. You don't trust these people. And you're claiming ownership. Well, you're claiming you owned the creation. Now, can you handle the bitch?
Okay. So as soon as you claim ownership, you're giving them the authority to take it?
Well, there's a controversy. They're the left hand of God, the way I look at it. You're saying you own God's shit. You think God's going to sit down for that? I give you everything to use. Now you want to claim ownership? Who the fuck you think you are?
Okay, so if you...
Well, if I'm using it...
Right.
Is that not ownership at the time I'm using it?
No. How's it ownership? It's there for me to use. Why? You think somebody needs it more than I do?
Well, it goes back to the... goes back to the possession is 9/10 of the law issue.
Well, the thing of it is, use it. The thing of it is... By you taking that money out of there, is that going to help? People fail to realize, in my opinion, that the government, so-called government, the people that work for the government, are only there for one reason, for controversy.
Yeah.
And if you relieve the notion of controversy by staying in honor and saying, I'm using it, is there a crime? I mean, what's the best way to settle this matter? You don't argue with them. You're there. You need it? You really need it that bad? And you'll find they won't take it.
Really?
I believe so. I've helped some people, even one lady with her children. She went in there, she just kept saying, I just want the best for the children. And you know what? The children are still with her. And they came at her all kinds of ways.
Interesting.
Yeah, imagine that. Could it be that simple?
Could it be that simple? Well, because typically the people you come across in, let's say, like in the IRS, those kinds of people, because they use psychological profiling to hire people who are, you know, good at taking orders and who seem to thrive on controversy, as you say.
Well, maybe. The thing of it is, they still have people over there. It's like Wendy, man. I was on a call last night. Now she's got people coming over to see her to help her move along. She's still living in a house over a year now that was foreclosed on.
Yeah.
And all she's been doing mainly is, she's been learning, messing up here and there, but that's learning. That's a good thing. You learn. But she just kept moving back in the house. After they moved her out, she'd move back in it. And now they're finally getting a message. She's just there using it, taking care of it. And they're leaving her alone. And now she's moving up, I think, the next step. They took her car, she called, or the car she uses anyway, and she made a call to the police, emailed them, I guess. It was on the last call. I might put it up on the back calls. I probably should. But now she's got people come and say, hey, I think there's some people you know, could help you on your journey. From the chief of police.
Really?
Yeah, imagine that.
Interesting.
The police are not our enemy. They're our friends. They're going to teach us how to get it right, even if it kills us. I'm telling you.
Very interesting. I've never heard of anybody being able to go to the IRS and settling and getting them to wipe out a tax bill.
You're talking about wiping out a tax bill. No, the only reason there's a tax bill is because somebody claimed ownership, creating a controversy. It ain't wiping out. They can zero the account at any time. The only thing they need to know is whether you're using it or owning it. Could it be that simple?
Interesting. You just said something there that I didn't hear in any of the other tapes, and that's really salient. Huh.
Would they know the difference between using it and owning it?
It's their job. What do you think? The lower echelon might give you a hard time, but it's going to take time. You've been doing it all your life, and all of a sudden you think overnight they're going to just say, hey, this guy's got it? Bullshit. You're going through the fire, buddy.
Okay. Yeah.
It's their job. They're the gatekeepers, man. Left hand of God, I call them. They're going to find out which side. You're either going to go to the right hand of God or you're going in the fucking trash barrel. It depends on your actions. They'll know you by your fruits. Think about it.
Huh. That's interesting. So when a person thinks that they're standing up for their rights, they're actually causing a controversy.
Well, can you prove you have any rights?
No.
See? So it's kind of fucking crazy to go out there. I got rights, yeah. That send this guy for a psyche eval. I'm with the judge on that one.
Well, there are pieces of paper in countries like, you know, the Bill of Rights, that kind of thing.
Well, it's for a bunch of assholes that think they got rights. My opinion.
What about liberties?
Well, liberty, if you got liberty, isn't it just the sense of the word? Somebody gave you liberty? And now you're bitching about what they gave you? What are you, fucked up?
My interpretation from the difference between rights and liberties is the rights are more of what they've been given, and the liberties are more of what God's given.
Well, what, you ever been served time on a ship?
No.
What did they give you, though? They give you liberty, shore leave.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now somebody gives you liberty. If somebody gives liberty, how can you claim liberty? I want my liberty. Does that make sense? If you got liberty,
yeah.
Why are you claiming it?
What is the biblical, since I get the impression a lot of the philosophy and processes that you teach are biblically based.
Well,
is that correct?
It appears to me that, you know, until you experience it, though, how are you going to know? But a lot that I read in the so-called Bible holds to be true. And the truth is self-evident, so I've been told. And if people ever stop to think about the shit they're claiming, what truth is it in there, you know?
Yeah. That's super deep.
Is it? Hey, I'm just an asshole, man. What do I know?
No, but it really is. Well, all truth has layers of deepness to it. That's one of the interesting things about the Bible is that it's like an onion.
Yeah.
It makes you cry.
Well, yeah. Yeah, well, it's hard to attack the Bible because it's got so much truth in it.
Well, the thing is the Bible, the way I was taught the Bible in the beginning, always confused me. And then all of a sudden it started to be so simple. It's weird when I found, hey, I'm screwing up here. And when I started taking little steps, all right, let me see what I can do to get this one right. And it just progresses. Now, I'm not saying that I got it right, but I'm just saying it appears to me it's right because I'm more at peace than I've ever been, if that makes any difference, you know?
Yeah.
And this is the kind of way I look at things now. It's all here to use, man. What's the problem?
Every time you claim ownership, whether it's claim ownership of property or the name or anything like that, then you cause a problem.
It's a controversy.
Yeah.
It's like the cross. What side of the cross, Jan? I believe it says in there, Christ allegedly said, I offer you the kingdom of heaven. He didn't say I gave it to you. He offered it to you, more or less. Offered it for you to use. It's your choice. You want to come now or not? One says, I accept the offer, and he says, right at this very moment, you're in the kingdom. The other one said, fuck no, I want to own it. Fine, here's the bill.
Yes.
Think about it.
Yeah, no, your discussion of Christ before Pontius Pilate was also an excellent example.
Yeah, he gives you out there how to deal with the courts, all in a nutshell. That's where I get it from. I cringe when I hear people, Batman's method. Give me a fucking break, people. I told you where it come from. Why are you blaming me for it?
Yeah, the fact that he was accused, he said, you say I am.
Yeah.
You say I am the king of the Jews. But he didn't rebut their assumption.
The name. He asked the question. You Robert so-and-so, you say I am. See? You king of the Jews? You say I am. It's name. It's claiming ownership. Christ, from what I gather, I don't recall him anywhere in the scriptures claiming ownership. Even when he was in the wilderness for 40 days and 40 nights, allegedly Satan or the devil, whatever you want to call him, maybe the ego, tapped him on the shoulder and said, hey, man, you know, all you got to do is bow down to me. Claim ownership. I'll give you the world. And he said, you know what he said? Why would I want to do that? Why buy the cow when I get the milk for free? I'm paraphrasing here, but, you know.
No, it's really interesting. It's a really interesting way of looking at it.
It's all through the scriptures, man. Even the Old Testament talks about it. You don't tax or like, if you're brothers, man, you know we're here using everything, and there's no tax, there's no usury with brothers, because we know it's here to use it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so,
Could it be the Illuminati's got the right idea? That's why so many people are out there calling them names.
They have the right idea how?
They honor one another. They honor everyone, unless people go into dishonor, and then they give them what they want. You want dishonor, you get dishonor. You want to stay in honor, you'll find honor.
So, well, I used to always tell people that wars were fought over real estate. Everybody wants to own real estate.
You know what wars are fought over? People's egos. They think they own something. Real estate, whatever you want to call it.
Sure.
And that's why I figure, I hope not, but the way it looks, two-thirds of the world, the ones that claim ownership, are going to kill each other off. And the one-third of the world that's just using it are going to be just fine and dandy.
Hmm.
What are you going to fight over if you're just using it? Can you, you know? You need it? I ain't using it? Let them have it. You'll find you'll get tenfold if when you need it.
Huh. Yeah. There's a lot to that.
Well, you want to talk with the Batman.
No, it's really good. It's really good. I just it's going to take me some time to download it all. But, yeah, you know, one of the things that we've done, and one of the things that Michael's very good at is questioning assumptions. It's more difficult for me because I'm still learning this stuff. But, you know, questioning the assumptions is what all courts do, of course.
Well, yeah, you go in there and who's the first witness against you?
Yourself if you cross the bar.
Well, there you go, if you cross the bar. Like, that freaking matters. I went all through that bullshit.
Oh, really?
No matter, I'd walk right up there. Judge, love you, brother. How can I help you settle this matter? It's irrelevant. It's another freaking illusion, man. Think about it. While you think about that, I gotta step out a minute.
Well, Michael?
Mm-hmm.
So, what about that? About...
Well, I agree with it. Because he's coming in as a man, right? So he's claiming that status through his actions and his words. He's not in there as a party to the action, right?
So if you cross the bar...
It's irrelevant in that regard because you're not a party to the action, as obvious by your words and your actions. So you maintain your status outside the jurisdiction of the court. But most people, it's safer for them to do it from outside as a demonstration.
Right.
Right? Because it demonstrates your position. And for clarity, I think it's like an educational step. When you know what you're doing, yeah, you can go in there and go all the way.
Okay.
But I don't think for people who don't...
weren't at that level yet.
No. And that's part of the problem I questioned earlier, right? Is a lot of the stuff that's taught is being taught as if you have a good foundation already of knowledge and understanding and experience. And it all makes sense when you have those things, but it doesn't make sense when you don't.
Right. Well, it's very interesting. So then what he's saying is called into question the way I've been approaching. I did approach CRA at first, much more respectfully, but as things have deteriorated, I've put on more of an armor.
Really? I never noticed.
So,
do you remember that letter that you were responding to asking for an appointment?
Yeah.
I kept telling you to tone it down because it was too confrontational.
Yeah.
Right? That's the first thing I picked up was you were, in fight mode, right? So the more you fight, the more you get fight.
Well, yeah. I don't want to fight. I want the controversy to go away.
Well, this is one of the things that Russ used to say at the beginning was, don't take it personally. It's got nothing to do with you, right? And we take it personally, so we get angry and we get defensive. And as soon as you really understand it's not about you, you don't get angry anymore. And you can move more into this attitude of, there's a mistake and how can we correct it? Because I know it's got nothing to do with me, right?
Okay.
Like I could call you an asshole and you could take it personally and get upset, or I could call you a purple people eater and you go, what the fuck is that? I don't care, because you don't have any emotional attachment and you know it's not true.
Yeah.
Right? So it's got nothing to do with you, so you don't get upset about it.
Yeah. Right? Well, I'm still wrapping my head around this whole idea that I don't know how we're going to educate them, although he says they know their job, but maybe not the low-level people, but the senior people. So the whole idea of them coming to try to take your money, money that is in the bank account that bears your name, however you want to define it, that still is a threat.
Right, but what if you listen to the I think it's number the second part, they talk about the fact that once they got recognized, then the system looked after their accounts for them.
Yeah.
Operate in one mode, but once you, pass, and he says like going through the fire, once you pass the tests, then the system, higher ups take accountability for it. That's the, the stories, anyways.
Well,
so it's like anything else. You got your foot soldiers who go in and do certain work, and you have other people who have to deal with the more advanced stuff.
Yeah. Interesting. Are you back?
I'm back.
Okay.
Batman Returns. So I noticed from the talkshoe account, where the calls are hosted, how does it work in terms of when you announce there's another call? Because
lately I don't. I just lately I've been having them on Thursdays. So on Thursday nights around 9. We're planning on another one if I'm able. I'll be there.
Is that 9 Eastern or?
Yeah. Eastern.
Eastern. Okay.
I got a couple calls. In fact, this one here too, I might put on the talkshoe.
So, what is your intention with these calls? What are you hoping to achieve with it?
Oh, everybody be happy, and the world will be a better place for me. How's that?
That's a wonderful intention. I share that intention.
I'm still fascinated by this idea that you can get somebody who's confrontational, like an IRS agent, and get them to, you know, they create these fictitious debts, and to get them to unilaterally withdraw them, I've never heard of that happening.
Do they? Do they create them, or is it the one who believes they own something that's creating it?
Well, if let's say you've received currency, you know, someone gave you money because they were happy about some service you performed, and the IRS guy comes along and says, "Oh, that's taxable income." Well, if you didn't file and he was not aware of it, then, you know, they're the one creating the controversy.
How'd you figure? He made you an offer. It's like I made you an offer. Would you like to have a talk today?
Okay. So if they say,
you might respond saying, "Hey, what makes you think I want to talk with you? Huh?" In other words, you say, "I owe this money." What do you mean, "I owe this money"? Who are you talking about in the first place? What evidence do you have that I own anything?
Well, I've done that, and they've said, "Well, we've got records that show that you received this money and it's taxable."
Really? Really? They're going to identify me? Sure, put them on the witness stand. Well, I will chat. I'm game.
But I'm not quite sure how you get around that. I mean,
it's there to get around. The point of the matter is they're looking at a piece of paper and they're saying that piece of paper is making a claim on you. Well, do you or do you not have a right to cross-examine them?
The piece of paper.
Well, other than that, what are they going on?
Well, but if a person is the one who wrote the piece of paper...
Get them in here.
The person?
Whatever, if there's such a thing.
Okay, so... So you get the IRS agent on the witness stand and say, what?
What you going to say? He's going to say, "I read the computer and it says this guy owes this much." So, it ain't going to go that far anyway, once I believe you make it a point, the standpoint about using stuff and being the name and you're just there to help settle the matter. They'll go away. So you would think you're going to lose. That's why you're coming up with all this bullshit. I believe it won't go that far, but if it does, ask questions. Who's prepared to give first-hand testimony that I owe anything or even own anything? Who's prepared? Who's going to put their balls on the table? Who's going to testify?
I'm just trying to anticipate what would happen. I haven't been in that position, but you're just anticipating and trying to think it through. So you think that, well, I haven't, Michael, haven't you read a transcript of a court case where something similar happened and the tax agent got on the stand and said, "Yeah, you know, I looked at the records and this person should have paid this much in taxes. He owes the system."
Yeah, this is a standard process, but then everybody's, you know, going into dishonor in various ways. So they play their game in court.
And didn't they accept the offer? In the end.
Well, if you say I do not accept your offer, you've sent me an offer here. You say I did this. I say I didn't do it, and I ask you to prove it. They just go ahead as if they didn't read those words.
What makes you think I'd say such a thing?
Okay, what would you say then?
I'd say I'd love to pay you. How can I pay you? Point of it is, it won't go that far if you stay on point with the name. Listen to the calls with Boris.
Yeah?
Looking for 5 years in freaking prison. All of a sudden, they don't want him in court anymore.
Yeah, and I've been listening to that one where he was talking with you and Shane and some other fellows.
Yeah, Shane, as far as I know, Shane accepted the offer. He's doing 3 years now.
Oh, so he still made a mistake even after all your calls?
I got the last transcript he had. He went in there and threw everything. The judge was telling him what to do, and he did the opposite.
Oh, boy.
It was funny reading the transcript. Figures. He threw everything at him but the kitchen sink, if you ask me. All the laws and rules and stuff he thought he knew. And the judge kept telling him, there's only one issue here at the moment, and that's sentencing.
Okay.
And he argued it, and he wound up accepting the offer of 3 years in prison he got.
So when the judge said that, he should have said...
I would have went in there. I believe there's a mistake. How can I help settle this matter honorably? It stayed on point.
Yeah. And then if they can't identify you, then it's not your liability?
Well, never mind identify you. The only one that can identify you is you by saying, yeah, that's my identification. Point of the matter is you went in there in honor. You tried to settle the matter honorably. The judge, see, he was hitting around it, and the judge knew he knew it, but... See, the thing of it is, in my opinion, Shane didn't believe it. He thought he needed all the laws and regulations to get him out of the trouble. He was looking for wooden idols to save his ass.
So, oh, I see.
Whereas all he had to do, the judge was telling him, if he stayed on point about a mistake in the matter and what evidence you have, it's my name, you know, what evidence you have, I own anything or something like that, stayed on point, there's a good chance he wouldn't have got sentenced. It would have been dismissed even after the trial.
So I understand this better. When the judge said, well, we're just here about sentencing,
yeah,
which sounds like a typical thing a judge would say, what would be your reply to that?
Good. Sentencing in a matter of the name? How can I help you settle this matter, Judge?
Ah.
He was trying to educate him.
Yeah, no, that doesn't work. That's their game.
Well, it's our game, too, man. The point of it is, why are we educating anybody when either you know it or you don't? Ignorance of the law is no excuse. Duh.
Yeah.
You think that judge is ignorant of the law?
No, it's his business.
Nobody's ignorant of the law, if you ask me. We all know it. We just choose to believe otherwise.
Yeah, people choose or try to not accept responsibility for their actions.
Well,
for sure.
Responsibility, to an extent, it's the only responsibility is how we treat one another. The rest is all here to use, man.
Yeah.
And the responsibility falls on you because if you're treating people like shit, guess what you're going to get?
Yeah, no, it absolutely works that way. It's amazing how... You show the slightest respect to people, and now they light up like a light bulb because so used to having people dump on them. It's amazing.
Yeah, tell the judge or tell that IRS agent, I trust you'll settle this matter honorably. Anything else I can do to help? Instead of bitching at them, you guys, this ain't even a lawful tax. Yeah, get a life.
Okay. So, well, this is very interesting and very refreshing for sure. I mean, I've actually been in the situation of having these written conversations with these agents, and the lower level guys do not get it.
Yeah.
They're task oriented, and they've been told by their superiors that they need to create a certain level of liability to pay their way.
Maybe true. Who knows? Point of the matter, it's irrelevant. If you treat them like your brothers and sisters, you'll get past that. May not seem like it, may seem like forever to get there. But like Wendy's a good example now. I think she got in touch with the higher echelon there, if there is such a thing. Or the lower echelon, maybe.
Yeah.
Whereas, you know, there's people allegedly said they understand where she's coming from. And it took her quite a bit to get to that point.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because, you know, it's fight or flight kind of response, isn't it?
Well, she did know. She went in there trying to, you know, allegedly as a peaceful inhabitant.
Yeah.
And she showed them that. And now it's starting to show its fruits. But like I tell people, you think it's going to happen overnight? I doubt it.
Well, yeah, they definitely
have a reputation out there of being a fucking dickhead. And now you want them to forgive you? It's not so much forgive you, but now you want them to believe you? You've been lying all these years, and all of a sudden you're going to start telling the truth? Yeah, good luck.
Yeah, they definitely have to test you, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, interesting. Well, you've answered all my questions, at least the ones I got for today. So thank you very much.
Yeah, glad to be of service.
That's great. Yes, thank you very much for your time and your efforts. It's
my time, my effort, what effort? Evidence you have it was any effort. Did I sound like I was straining?
I'm just trying to be courteous, brother.
Is that courteous or is that accusing your brother? Could you be misled?
I don't know.
All right, sir. Well, I hope you have a great afternoon and evening.
Whatever. They're all great. Once you see it's just a gift and enjoy the moment, I think you'll find it gets better every day. Every moment.
All right. All right. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Batman.
Peace be with you.
And you.